Very good morning, students. Myself Vinod Bhati, continuing our chapter number 2, microorganism, friends and foe. Yesterday in our previous video, we have studied about the microorganisms. What are the microorganisms? Those organisms which are very small and cannot be seen by naked eye are known as microorganisms, such as fungi, protozoa, bacteria, viruses, etc. Now today we will discuss about the common diseases caused by microorganisms. In our previous videos, we have also studied about the microorganism as our friends, how they are acting as our friend by performing various functions or helping us, whereas some of the bacteria or the microorganism are harmful for us and so act as a foe, means enemy also. Now the microorganisms is carried by certain organisms that are known as carriers. Carriers are those organisms which carries these microorganisms to the person or the other organisms. Such carriers such as mosquito, housefly and other mode insects can be there which carries these microorganisms. So those organisms which carries these microorganisms are known as carrier. For example, mosquito, housefly, etc. Now the common diseases caused by the microorganism, here I have shown a table. This table is given in your textbook also, that in that first human disease, the second column has causative microorganism, third mode of transmission and fourth preventive measures, in which the first disease is tuberculosis. Tuberculosis is a disease, we also know named it as a TB. In short, it is named as TB. Tuberculosis disease, it is caused by a bacteria, Mycobacterium tubecti is the bacteria through which this disease is being caused, and the mode of transmission is air. Basically, this bacteria is transferred from an infected person to a healthy person through air. So the mode of transmission is air. So what we have to take the preventive measure so that person does not suffer from this disease, that person should be completely isolated. If there is an infected patient in our surrounding, we can isolate the patient. Patient should be away from the other person. It should be isolated in another rooms. Second, vaccination at suitable age. There is a vaccination for the tuberculosis disease so that person does not suffer from this disease. So we can have a vaccination at a suitable age, means in children we can give the vaccination and through which we can protect them from this disease. Next, DOTS program. DOTS program is also done in the 15 days vaccination and medicines is being given to the patient so that patient will recover and does recover from this disease properly. Now next, measles. Measles is another disease and it is caused through the viruses. Measles is caused by the viruses and this virus is transmitted through air. This virus is also transmitted through air. So in air, this virus can be there and from that the person may suffer from the disease called as measles. In that also we have to complete isolation of the patient. Patient should be completely isolated. Then vaccination should be there at the suitable age. In children, there are BCG vaccination is there to protect them from measles and tuberculosis and polio diseases, chickenpox diseases. There are vaccines are present. Next, after that, keep away the personal belonging from the others. Personal belongings means the things which are being used by the infected persons that are known as his personal belongings, and this thing should be away from the other persons or other family members so that they does not come in contact with these viruses or the bacteria, and in order that we can protect them from these diseases. Next, after that, the third one, chickenpox. Chickenpox is a disease caused by a virus, and this virus can be spread through air or the physical contact with the patient. It can be transmitted with the help of the air, means the virus can be in air or with the physical contact with the patient. You have seen in our India, there is a particular season near the Holi festival. This virus is most popular in our India, that children are suffering from this chickenpox disease. So in that time, we should make sure that our children should not get this disease or affected by this virus. So again, the same preventive measures, the patient should be completely isolated, vaccination should be there, and keep away the personal belongings. Next after that, the fourth one, polio. Polio is a disease which is also caused by a virus, and this virus can be spread through air or a contaminated water. Water, if the water contaminated by this virus, means this virus substances are present in the water, then person, while taking this water, they can suffer from this polio disease. So we should prevent them use of the contaminated water. Again, the preventive measures are same: complete isolation of the patient, vaccination at a suitable age, and keep away the personal belongings. Next, cholera. Cholera is a disease which is caused by the bacteria disease, Mycobacterium vibrio. This disease is caused by the bacteria, and this bacteria can be present in our contaminated food or water. If person takes the contaminated food or water, then person can suffer from the cholera disease. And what are the preventive measures? So preventive measures are: maintain personal hygiene and good sanitary habits. If a person is suffering from a cholera disease, then we should have personal hygiene, means the toilet which are being used by the patient should be clean and it should be maintained hygiene. And the sanitary habits should be good. The sanitary habits means while after using the toilet, we should have should clean our hands or body parts with a clean water and by using the soap, etc., so that our we should clean our all body parts and we should not suffer from this bacteria. Next after that, typhoid. Typhoid is a disease caused by the bacteria, and this bacteria can be spread or transmitted through the contaminated water, means the contaminated water may contain this bacteria and can cause typhoid disease. Again, the same thing, the we should maintain the personal hygiene and good sanitary habits should be there. Consume properly cooked food and boiled water. While we when we cook the food properly, then the bacteria will die because of high temperature, and when we boil the water, the bacteria present in the water will die, and after filtering we can use that water. So next after, there is another disease, hepatitis A. Hepatitis A is a disease caused by the viruses, and these viruses are also present in the contaminated water. So the mode of transmission of the hepatitis A virus is contaminated water. What are the preventive measures? We should drink the boiled water, and vaccination is there. There are two types of vaccination, hepatitis A for hepatitis A and hepatitis B. In the children, the vaccination is being given so that it can be prevented from this type of diseases. Next after, the last disease known as malaria. Malaria is a disease caused by the protozoa. Especially for the malaria, the protozoa is Plasmodium. Plasmodium protozoa is there which causes the malaria. This Plasmodium protozoa is present in the mosquito's intestine, and the female Anopheles mosquito is responsible for spreading this malaria disease. So what are the preventive measures so that we can prevent our kids or ourselves also from the malaria disease? Use mosquito net and repellent. We can use the mosquito net for sleeping at night, and repellent. Mosquito repellent can be in the form of the coils, in the form of drops such as All Out, Good Night, etc. So mosquito repellents and mosquito net should be there. Control breeding of the mosquitoes. As in our surrounding, there in the small pits or the waste material such as tin, etc., tires, etc., in that the water can be collected, and this in this collected water or the stagnant water, the mosquito can lay their eggs, and due to that they can breed in that water. So we should control the breeding of the mosquitoes by spreading the DDT powder or the other medicines, so that the mosquito should not be breed in that stagnant water. Our surrounding should be clean so that there should not be water being collected by the rain, and we can control the breeding of the mosquitoes. Thank you. You have understand that table, I think. You are able to understand this. Yes. So the microorganism which cause the diseases in animals are known as animal microorganisms. So such as anthrax. Anthrax is a microorganism which causes diseases in human beings and the cattle. Basically, this anthrax is a cattle microorganism which causes diseases in the anthrax disease in cattle, and in that the nostrils burst of the cattle, and due to that the blood comes out and even the animal will die due to that disease. Next, the diseases caused by the microorganism in plants are known as plant microorganisms. So I have seen shown here in a table some of the plant diseases caused by the microorganism. The first one disease is citrus canker. Citrus canker disease is caused in lemon. That is a disease caused in lemon in which the lemon leaves becomes yellowish in color. Yellow spots are present on the lemon leaves, and due to that the flower does not develop on the lemon, and due to that no fruits is developing on the plant. It is caused due to the bacteria, and it can be transmitted through the air. In the air the bacteria can be there, and due to that the citrus canker disease can be occurred in plants. Next, rust of wheat. Rust of wheat is a disease caused by the fungi. Actually, the fungi affect the wheat plant, and due to that the wheat barley, means the wheat seeds, does not develop, and due to that it becomes brownish powder, and due to this fungi it can be spread through air or seeds. Next, the yellow bean mosaic of Bhindi. Bhindi scientifically known as, the scientific name is okra. In okra, the yellow bean mosaic means the leaves of the Bhindi or the okra ladyfinger, this beans becomes yellowish in color, and their flower does not develop, and due to that it affects the fruit formation on the plants, and this can be spread through the insect. So that are the diseases. So today we have studied about the diseases caused by the microorganisms in animals and caused by the microorganism in plants. I hope it will beneficial to you. If any doubt, you can WhatsApp me. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay home and stay safe.